can AI write a PhD thesis better than I can? And can the creators of Google's NotebookLM tell my writing from the chatbots? Stay tuned to find out if AI can outwrite me and outwit its creators. Imagine spending years buried in research, sifting through mountains of information, painstakingly writing a PhD thesis, only to graduate and discover that there's now an AI tool that can do so much of that heavy lifting. Well, that was me. I finished my PhD in early 2024, right before the major wave of AI tools like ChatGPT and NotebookLM really hit the mainstream. And now, as a science communicator, I actually use these tools all the time, especially NotebookLM, because it helps me quickly decode and organize information. So can this AI tool really write at a PhD level, or is there still a human touch it just can't quite replicate? Let's find out. All right, so let's dive into NotebookLM, this new tool that has quickly become my favorite tool post-PhD research life. Unlike other AI chatbots that pull from the internet, NotebookLM lets you upload your own documents, so it will ground its responses specifically in your sources that you give it. So that means if I upload academic papers or notes, it only pulls information from those sources, which keeps it more accurate and relevant to exactly what I'm working on. No random answers or guesswork. But what makes NotebookLM so special is that it doesn't just pull information. It organizes, it summarizes, and even helps spark new ideas by making connections across different documents. Think of it like a supercharged research assistant who gets stuff straight from your sources. Later I'll show you exactly how it works, but first, let's head to Google HQ in California, where I got the chance to sit down with two minds behind NotebookLM.
Well, I mean, on my end, it's been kind of an obsession in my life since I was like 18 in the late 1980s with this idea of like tools for thought and, you know, using software in some way to help you research and write and develop your ideas. And so when, you know, language models came on the scene in a real way, a couple years ago, Google Labs had just been created. Raiza had just joined, one of the early Labsters. And Josh Woodward and Clay Bavor, who at that time Clay was running Labs, reached out to me, having read my books and other things, and said, hey, you know, we think we could finally build that dream research assistant kind of tool now that we have these language models. You know, would you like to come and be a part of it? And at Labs, we have this culture of co-creation, where instead of just like a bunch of technologists building stuff and then giving it to creators or users, the idea is you bring in some of those creators from the beginning of the life cycle of the product and work with them. And so I was kind of the first guinea pig for that, for Labs.
It's so crazy because it feels so long ago, but also it was only 2 years ago. Yeah. But I remember when I first joined Labs, I was working on AI Test Kitchen, and it was the first AI product that we were going to publicly ship. And a lot of the application, as we were both starting to use the technology ourselves and prepare to share it with others, a lot of it was fun and exploratory. But as we were doing that, I realized, I was like, wait a second, this is going to be really transformative in a lot of different ways.
When we see somebody griping about Notebook on Twitter or something like that, like you just did this the other day, like somebody was like, Notebook was kind of disappointing. And like, I saw on the calendar that like the head of Labs Raiza had arranged like a meet with this guy and it was like to actually like find out like what was the problem. And it was just like, wow.
It was a really great interaction too, because I think we're so familiar with Notebook that our usage of it is different, right? Yeah. Because of our knowledge of how it works and the gap. So of course we use it in sort of the best possible way. But every time there is a new user or someone who's willing to give it a shot and they say, wow, you know, that thing sucked or it didn't do what I thought it was going to do, I especially want to know what
You're
was the thing.
You're good at leaning into that stuff. Right? I'm like, they must have misunderstood it. I don't
They didn't read the manual. Yeah.
What's the problem with them? Our new models have these like much larger context windows, right? So that they can kind of think about, you know, you can think of a context window as kind of like the short-term memory of the model. And so we're constantly taking information from your sources and putting it into the context window of the model.
I would say too, when thinking about how NotebookLM works, a lot of the way that it's built mirrors a lot of that research process that we've seen people do before LLMs and even with LLMs, which is, you know, if I'm trying to write a paper, particularly, for example, I digest a lot of research. I kind of write my own one-page summary saying, here's my POV based on it. I typically will read the paper and then I'll try to pull out the pieces that really jump out at me. So I might care about one particular thing. I might say, you know, what's overall Gen Z usage of this particular device? So I'll find those pieces, I'll pull them out. And then from there, I'll say, okay, what am I really trying to elucidate from this? And then I might use statistics, I might say my opinion, but NotebookLM is doing the same thing, which is you might just ask that question instead of doing that whole thing. You might just say, what's the Gen Z usage of this particular device? And it does that finding of the passages for you, except the capability, of course, you know, across 25 million words to do it in seconds, that I think is sort of the leap we're seeing with this technology. Yeah.
All right, let's first walk you through how to get started with NotebookLM. First things first, you access notebooklm.google.com. Once there, you'll be prompted to upload your sources. And this is where it gets really versatile. You can upload Google Docs, Google Slides, PDFs, text documents, websites, YouTube videos, copied text, and now even audio files, which I haven't tried yet, but it sounds really interesting. Whatever format your research or your reference materials are in, NotebookLM will handle it. Once you've uploaded your sources, NotebookLM immediately gets to work. The tool starts by summarizing the documents for you, automatically highlighting main points, and even suggesting questions you might want to ask based on your sources. So this gives you a quick overview of the material, which is incredibly helpful when you're working with a lot of information. Wait a second, that's a new feature I haven't used yet, but this must have been what Spotify used to make our Wrapped AI podcast this year, which was random, but I digress. I reckon I can recreate my Spotify AI Wrapped podcast by writing down all of my Spotify Wrapped data, putting it into a document, uploading it to NotebookLM, and letting this audio thing deep dive podcast run. The real one that came in my Spotify Wrapped and the one that I just generated with NotebookLM are both incredibly cringe in such a hilarious way. I personally like all of the little reactions that come from both of the AI hosts.
Wow.
Yeah.
You're dang.
No slow.
Fun.
What a vibe.
Bye.
Anyway, back to the video. And interacting with NotebookLM is as simple as having a conversation. You can use the chat interface to ask specific questions about the sources. And if you want to quickly check a particular concept or term, you can just ask and it will pull out relevant information straight from the documents you give it. But here's a feature I really appreciate. NotebookLM's in-text citation system. Every response it generates is backed by citations, and that will link directly back to the source material you have given it. So all you have to do is hover over on these citations, and it will show you exactly where that information comes from. This makes it so much easier to double check what NotebookLM is presenting to you and the accuracy of what it's presenting to you. This tool makes handling large volumes of information way more efficient. And I mean large volumes of information. A single notebook allows you to upload up to 50 different sources, with a total word count of those sources being up to 25 million words. That is insane. And that's how simple it is to get started with NotebookLM. Now let's see if Stephen and Raiza can pick out what's written by yours truly or what's crafted by NotebookLM.
So I thought that I would challenge NotebookLM.
Okay.
To see if we can match the sort of literature review that I had written for my PhD. And so I'm going to give you guys three examples of something that's been written by NotebookLM versus what is actually in my PhD thesis.
Oh my gosh.
So here's the first example.
Okay, I have a guess for the first one.
Okay.
I don't know.
My guess would be Notebook wrote number two.
Yes, the first one, number two, is written by NotebookLM.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
I mean, that was the one thing I felt like that sounded like Notebook, the just as archaeologists carefully excavates, but I wasn't sure. It's partially because I don't know your style. Mm-hmm. So it's a little tricky. Yeah, yeah. That's true. Yeah.
Oh, example two, let's go.
I guess I would say that doesn't, I would have said maybe it was one. I don't know.
Is that your guess? Is this is your guess?
I think that this.
Okay, we'll take turns guessing. This is Stephen's guess.
You're correct.
Okay.
Okay, we're already.
Okay, good. Okay.
We can get this.
Better than chance.
Okay, we have to have a consensus vote on this
one. I don't really know.
Okay, I'm gonna guess number two.
Is Notebook.
Number two is written by me.
So after diving deep into NotebookLM, here are my final thoughts. This tool is genuinely so powerful for synthesizing existing information and making connections between sources way faster than I ever could on my own. So if you've got a stack of research papers and need to find common threads, NotebookLM is like having a supercharged assistant to sort and link everything together in record time. But now to the big question, can it actually write a whole PhD thesis? No. PhD research is all about contributing new information to the world in very niche subjects. NotebookLM excels with what's already there, but it can't synthesize brand new insights from original observations, which is really the core of any thesis. That said, could it handle a literature review? Absolutely. I can definitely see it being a fantastic support in that part of a PhD thesis, with its ability to organize timelines, track historical developments, and summarize complex ideas. It's incredibly helpful for gathering and structuring existing knowledge, which is a huge part of any lit review in a thesis. In the end, NotebookLM has definitely earned a permanent spot in my research toolkit. I have found it so useful for my work post-PhD, and I am honestly excited to see where the creators take it next.